This video is provided as supplementary material for courses taught at Howard Community College. And in this video, I'm going to talk about the properties of trapezoids and show how to prove those properties. So let's start with the definition of a trapezoid. A trapezoid is a quadrilateral, so it's a four-sided figure, and it's got one pair of parallel sides. Now, I've drawn a quadrilateral, a four-sided figure, that I've labeled A, B, C, D. And I'm going to mark side BC as being parallel to side AD. So this is a trapezoid. I've got a property here that says consecutive angles between parallel sides are supplementary. Well, angle A and angle B are consecutive angles. If I go around this trapezoid, angle A and angle B come after one another. And they're between the two parallel sides, BC and AD. I want to show that they're supplementary. So what I'm going to do is extend side AB so that I form an exterior angle at B. Now, there's that exterior angle, and right next to it is the interior angle. These two angles together form a straight line, a 180-degree angle, which means that they're supplementary angles. Now, side AB is a transversal that intersects parallel lines BC and AD. So that means the angle at A has to be congruent with the exterior angle at B, because they're corresponding angles along a transversal. The exterior angle at B is supplementary to that interior angle at B. So that means angle A must also be supplementary to it. So therefore, these two interior angles, consecutive angles between parallel sides, are supplementary. Now, in the same way, I could go over to angles C and D and show that they're supplementary. So that's our property for all trapezoids. Consecutive angles between the parallel sides are supplementary to each other. Now we have a special kind of trapezoid, a specific kind, which is called an isosceles trapezoid. An isosceles trapezoid is a trapezoid with a pair of congruent base angles. Let's understand what that means. I've got a trapezoid that I've drawn, and I label the parallel sides BC and AD. Now, when we talk about trapezoids, the parallel sides are very often called the bases. And this definition says that there's a pair of congruent base angles. So angle A and angle D would be congruent base angles. They would have the same measure. And then we have this property. The property says each pair of base angles is congruent. So in other words, A and D are congruent, but the other pair, B and C, would also have to be congruent. Here's how we'll prove that. Angle A and angle B are consecutive angles between the parallel sides, between the bases, so they must be supplementary to each other. Now, angle B would also have to be supplementary to angle D, since A and D are congruent. Then we've got angle C, and angle C has to be supplementary to D, because they're consecutive angles between the parallel sides. So if angle D and angle B are supplementary, and angle D and angle C are supplementary, angle B and angle C must equal each other. Okay, so that's our property, a pair of base angles. Each pair of base angles are congruent. Now we've got another property. It says a pair of opposite sides are congruent. So we're going to want to show that side AB is congruent with side CD. Let me get rid of some of my notation here so we can see this clearly. What I'm going to do is I'm going to draw a perpendicular line from B down to the base AD. When I draw that perpendicular line, it's going to form a right angle with the base. I'm going to draw another perpendicular line from C down to the base, and that will form a right angle. So I've made two triangles. I can show those triangles are congruent. Angle A and angle D are congruent angles. The two right angles are congruent. And now I just have to show that those two perpendiculars are congruent, so I can have angle-angle-side congruency. Those perpendiculars that I drew are the distance. Each one measures the distance between the two parallel sides, between the bases. Now, when you have parallel lines, the distance is constant. Distance is always the same. So both of these perpendicular lines are going to be congruent with each other. They'll be the same length. Therefore, I have two congruent triangles, and that means that side AB is going to be congruent with the corresponding side CD. So I've got a pair of opposite sides, AB and CD, that are congruent. Now, my last property says the diagonals are congruent. So once again, let me get rid of some of the markings that I've drawn in and show that the diagonals are going to be congruent. So I'll draw the diagonals in. I'm going to have a line connecting BD, B and D, and another diagonal from A to C. I want to show that those two diagonals are congruent with each other. So I've formed two triangles. One triangle would be BAD, and the other triangle would be CDA. If I can show that those two triangles are congruent, then it would mean that those diagonals, which are corresponding sides of the two triangles, would also be congruent. So let's see. I know that BA is congruent with CD. So I've got two sides, I've got a pair of sides that are congruent. I know that angle A is congruent with angle D. So I've got two angles that are congruent. And both of the triangles share the same base, AD. So I've got side, angle, side congruency for the two triangles. That means that their corresponding sides, AB and DC, I'm sorry, we're doing the diagonals. That means their corresponding sides, AC and DB, are going to be congruent. Those are the diagonals, and therefore the diagonals are congruent. Okay, so those are your three properties for isosceles triangles. Both pairs of base angles are congruent. So A and D were congruent, B and C were congruent. There's a pair of congruent opposite sides, and the diagonals are congruent. Okay, take care. I'll see you next time.